Hi everyone, this is Tushar, and I'll be talking about the project I've been working on, which relates to generating smart release logs. So our objective is to build, after a release happens, maybe we can aggregate the commits together, maybe bugs together, feature improvements collected together. So I had to work on individual commits as well as pull requests for generating this smart release document. And as I talked about in my first demo, so I was previously using unsupervised learning based approaches, like Srishti was talking about the clustering based approach. It was pretty similar. So I was able to cluster around maybe like 80% of the bugs were correctly classified. And there were some labeling issues that were there in that approach. I used that approach because I didn't have any labeled data set. I couldn't find any data set at that time. But over the past 2 weeks, I found like two, three big data sets that I can use. I'll just start my screen share now. So this is the paper I've been referring to. This is done by the two Brazilian researchers who had been working on commit classification using NLP. So what they did was they basically aggregated three, four big data sets from multiple open source projects like React.js, RxJava, Hadoop, and they actually got together and they manually annotated all the commits. So I'll just walk through around basically the nomenclature they've been using. So that is the same thing I'll be using now. If you can see it, all the commits they have been classified as corrective, which are basically bug fixes, features that are new features. Perfective is basically improvements upon previous features. So it's similar to corrective, but it's like more focused on improvements. And there are non-functional commits as well. Those are merge commits or maybe version upgrades or something. And there's an unknown class as well. So whatever doesn't come up in the first four classes, it goes to unknown. This is pretty much the standard nomenclature that everyone uses for commit classification. And in this paper, they also talked about the model they will be using. Like, so they are referring the FastText library. So it was developed at Facebook by the authors of Vertuvec library. So it's kind of an upgrade over Vertuvec. It was released, it was open sourced around 3 years ago. It generally works better than Vertuvec as well as Glove Vectors. So this is what I've been using. This is the classification notebook I built. First of all, I just cleaned up the data set, used the FastText library. It's actually a pretty simple library to use. Just in a single line, you can train the supervised model. So this is the train set I've been using. Contains 5,000, I think 5,200 commits. Was developed by those researchers. I just train it over, it just takes 5 minutes. It's pretty fast. Save the model. Then after that, I've been using it for classifying all the commits in the OpenShift repository. We're using the OpenShift origin repository for here. And the PyKit tool I talked about in the last demo, it's really good actually. It makes me it's easily to it, I can easily access all the commits in the repository as Python objects. So there are 32,000 commits in the origin repository. So I just ran my classifier over it. Predicts labels for all these individual commits. As you can see, the merge requests have been labeled as non-functional. Some features have been labeled, some corrective the commits have been labeled as well. So I saw a lot of commits from these from this labels, and I think most of them were classified correctly, but there was some confusion between corrective and features as well. And some were classified as non-functional while they were actually bug fixes. So after this, I talked to Frido and Christoph about what should I do next. So they suggested that I should maybe try working on pull request labels rather than individual commits. That is the next thing that I did. I ran the same classifier over pull request messages. That is all the merge commits. So the PyKit library allows me to actually get commits which have two parents, that is there. They are merge commits. But the problem with merge commits is that the first line doesn't give me any information. Merge pull request from this, from the source branch and user name and the number of the pull request label. That doesn't make any sense for us. So I just removed that first line from all the pull request labels. So this thing eventually becomes this. I just get the bug thing, storage E2 is leaving named ports. So I did this for all the merge commits, that is all the pull requests on the OpenShift repository. So got around 12,000 pull requests. So these are the 12,000 merge commits. I ran the same model and I got the labels for them, like bugs, latest owners, disabled broken. So I can see the corrective fixes, perfective ones and features as well. So this works pretty well as well, but for actually objectively identifying what is the accuracy measure, so I need a new test data set. That is what I've been working on. And all these labels that I've been classified are actually put on Google Drive. All of you can see this. These are all the commits of the OpenShift repository that have been labeled by this algorithm. All the PR pull request labels as well. So the next step for actually quantifying the accuracy, I've been developing my own test data set that I can run different algorithms and maybe compare which one is better. So this is what I've been building right now. So I've been taking help from the labels of GitHub labels as well. So because in the OpenShift repo, some PRs are correctly classified as bugs. So that actually helps me in getting the labels correctly. But not all features have been marked. And some pull requests don't have any labels. They can be bug as well. They can be non-functional. They can be anything. So this requires some manual effort. So currently I've actually labeled 30 commits and I've added links so that anybody can review and maybe change the commits. And there's one more thing I've been doing. Actually marking them the first priority label as well as the second priority. If I feel something is corrective, I'll put up there as well. But the second closest label I can think of, I'm also putting that. That I can compare maybe with some other developer, they may change the labels, and I have a second person account as well. So this is pretty much the status of the project. And there are a few more things I can do. As Frido suggested, I can package this Python script or the notebook as a CLI tool so that it can actually be used. And second thing is expanding this data set to include I'm targeting around 200 commits so that I can test my algorithms on it. And third thing is I can use new state of the art approaches like GPT-3 that was recently open sourced by OpenAI and some old models like BERT. So basically transformer based models, which should work better. But before that, I need to build up this data set so that I can actually compare which one is better. So that's it for the demo. Any suggestions or questions, welcome.
Do you have an idea of how your work could help the OpenShift Kubernetes cluster community with pull requests and commit messages?
We can actually aggregate different pull requests. So maybe for release 1.2 or 1.3, we can generate logs that this percentage of commits were actually corrective. This percentage were feature improvements. We can actually relate authors as well. So we can actually categorize these developers are working on feature fixes. These developers are working on documentation fixes. So all this information can be published along with release logs.
Mm-hmm. So it's in the end, or the vision is that we have a very well-structured release note, which is focusing on individual topic areas. So for example, documentation has been updated by these three guys, and there have been a lot of errors. And to me, it feels like we could also put some topic labels on it. So not only that the documentation has been updated and these are the actual pull requests, but these have been the pull requests on network documentation or on installation documentation, so that we have like a little bit of semantical structure in the release note.
I look into
Cool.
that, but
Yeah, would be cool if we can create a tiny service that is basically spitting out an enhanced release note section for this current release. Nice. Thanks. Any other questions? Cool. Thanks.
I just have a question. It was about so you said you were picking up comments from pull requests. And if you're using the merge commit, isn't that the same commit which would be the first commit in the pull request? Like if there are four commit messages put in, the merge commit would be accounting for the just same title which
No,
has
actually
the like
the
which
merge commit message would contain the pull request title. That's what I observed.
Okay, so it
Whichever
could
title you
first
put up in the pull request, that will come up in the message of the merge commit.
I see. Okay.
You touched slightly what I wanted to say offline, but if community is behaving in a nice way, you create a pull request, you state what feature or what enhancement or what fix you are targeting. So you create that message in the pull request, and it can consist of multiple pull requests into different modules, different parts of the project. So it might be a good idea to detect which parts were coming from pull requests, for example, based on a merge commit. And then go to GitHub, GitLab, or whatever service is used for source management and obtain a pull request or merge request message body and use it to use that message to classify what was coming into the project. And possibly generate a change log entry out of it.
Thanks, Tushar. Thanks, the others, for the comments.